Should we go find the Harbinger? I suppose we should find the Harbinger. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with that. I also want to go to this tavern first. So let's go to the tavern and then we'll go to find the Harbinger, the Prophet. The Harbinger of Death.
And Decay.
He will kill you. He will kill you all! You got the one job! It's dangerous! Move out of the way and I will rip your dirty wood off ears off. It's a nice picture. Or rug. Are you the person? No. Cooking fire, let's cook something. Small game. Rabbit myth. Level 15 it has to require article. Ooh. Okay. So I can craft it, but it's level 15 so I can't eat it? Is that
I bring fragrant elixirs and delicate blends. What can I get you?
You cannot get me anything. I'm looking for the quest giver in this goddamn pisshole. Is it you?
You are needing a good meal, yes?
No, I'm not. He must be upstairs.
And you are?
Stephen. Fire monk. Whatever you want to call me. The bringer of death. Anything. Okay, so... What, I don't want to say things in chat. Okay. This is gold.
Greetings, Milksop. You must be lost. This is where undaunted drink, not Milksops. Now go away, Milksop. This one does not want to catch your Milksoppiness.
I'm not a smokesop. I've fought scarier things than you can imagine. No, literally, I've come from the dead back to life without my soul, because I left that behind because I didn't want that dragging me down, you know what I mean? I mean, that whole 0.0000 pounds that you took up, just too much, man. And then I fought that big, you know, blue thing, so I'm not no milksop, okay, lad?
You've probably fought what? Some mud crabs and malnourished bandits?
I have fought mud crabs.
I want to tackle the big things, scary things.
Really?
Found only in the dark places of the world.
What?
Things with flesh-eating fists, hungry for your face.
Flesh-eating fists. So he's got a mouth on his fist that eats your face. This creature I have to see.
We are thrill-seeking adventurers, everyone. We aren't mercenaries like the Fighters Guild, or patriots like the Dominion.
Okay.
We fight to prove we're the toughest of the litter.
Of the litter.
You want in? You'll have to prove yourself.
Yeah, why not?
That's the spirit.
Speed.
What's a centuries-old cursed bloodline in the face of unmitigated bravado? Enter the banished cells,
okay.
Stay a while, maybe bother a ghost. If you come out alive, see me at the tavern in Volkelgard. We'll talk more then.
Okay, will you help me in the Boric cells? Obviously he's not going to help you. Don't be dumb, man. Who's dumb enough to say that? He's not going to help you. He's like, you got to prove yourself. You've got to prove yourself. Which means he's not going to help you. Okay, let's see what we got. This way, that way, every freaking way. I don't know what I'm doing.
My temper is short.
This is so much I got to do. Alright. Also, I want to see the guy who dragged me out the water as well. But I'm just... This is so much to do. So I just can't do all it. So, yeah. What can I say? Come on. Keep running. And jump! Like a boss! We definitely need a horse. Definitely need a horse. Should we talk to this guy? Like, should we actually go over to the place and see him? I'm not really... What are you doing? He's shooting somebody. I didn't do anything, so yeah, get stuffed. He just killed him though, so that's a craziness. Okay, guys, so let's go find this bloody harbinger. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. I was meant to press shift to run, but I pressed the wrong. What? Hey, buddy!
Move along.
Okay. She's not a nice person. Well, how's that? It's another player. Hey! Oh. Oh, it's a solo. This is a dungeon. Solo dungeon. Once the prophet was a man of vigilance, not of vigor and strength. Some harrowing experience has aged his and diminished, leaving him blind and almost feeble. But reading the Elder Scrolls can do that to a person.
Daddy.
What the hell is this? This is insane.
This is your Bobby.
Very, very close quarters. It's almost scary.
I hear familiar footfalls. Come closer, Bessie.
Dude! That is so nice. This guy. Not a scrub at all, is he? The fudge is that? You're a necromancer, I'm gonna have to kill you. I don't like necromancers. Okay? Look at that, that's so nice. Look at that, he's cooking a fish. The prophet.
Welcome to the harbourage vestige.
Okay.
This is as comfortable a home as an old dried up husk like myself could hope for.
But you could go anywhere.
Despite my blindness, nay, because of it, my other senses seem to have heightened. This place had the right smell about it.
Because of all the flowers? When you first appeared into me in Cold Harbor, you spoke of my destiny.
Indeed, but let us not get ahead of ourselves. Without an understanding of where we are bound, every road will get us nowhere.
Yeah, it'll get us somewhere.
Before we understand our destination, we must speak of the past.
Okay, a history lesson. Excellent.
Officer, I invite you to enter my mind and walk with me through visions of the past.
What with
you? Understand the events that brought us to this time, this moment.
Yippee!
Sure, why not?
Enter my mind, Vestige. And walk with me through the shadows of past events.
I like the way your magic is flowery and butterflies. I mean, hey, what's up?
Follow me, Vestige, and learn of the events that precipitated our current crisis.
I don't want to run too much.
My part in the story began when I awoke on the steps of the Abbey of the Moth Priests, with no memory of my prior life.
Not memory, they're not butterflies then, they're moths.
The Moth Priests took pity upon me and brought me into their fold.
Okay.
I was weak and near death.
And you're an old man. Come on.
It was there I first set eyes upon the Elder Scrolls.
Yep, I thought you were.
My life to their study.
Thought so. Had a feeling that you...
The scrolls allowed me to glimpse the very fabric of reality. But each profound insight dimmed my vision and eventually left me permanently blinded to the light of the world.
Fool. You must train for years.
The prophecies of the Elder Scrolls are a fluid living thing. They are not fixed. At many points throughout history, the actions of heroic mortals have rewritten them.
What does this have to do with me?
I only know that you are important, Vestige. The scrolls reveal to me that your destiny is intertwined with that of the Five Companions.
The Five Companions? Who are they?
The
five companions were a band of adventurers who sought out an ancient artifact called the Amulet of Kings. They hoped to use this artifact to persuade Akatosh, the dragon god, to accept their leader as one of the Dragonborn.
Interesting.
Baron Aquilarius, the son of Calobian Duke, who led a rebellion against the Emperor Leovic and took the crown himself. Alas, Baron was not truly a Dragonborn, as those who sit upon the Ruby Throne must be, in accordance with tradition.
Yeah, and that's where the Oblivion thing takes up, and that you get Martin and all that.
You have already heard enough babbling from this old blind fool.
Okay.
It is time you met the five companions yourself.
I don't want to.
Witness their thing.
Yeah, come on.
The first companion, Lyris Titanborn, daughter of giants, was the mightiest warrior in the service of the Emperor.
Okay.
Next, Abner Tharn, a powerful sorcerer and Grand Chancellor to the Imperial Elder Council. The Red Guard Swordmaster, Sai Sahan, leader of the Imperial Dragon Guard.
I like a sword.
The Imperial Emperor, Baron Aquilarius, who attempted to light the dragon fires and failed.
Huh.
And finally, Manamarco, the traitor, the king of worms.
Manamarco.
For necromancer, and your executioner.
There are a lot of links to Oblivion here, like the lighting the dragon fires, Manamarco. And if you couldn't light the dragonfires, that would let Maroon's Dagon invade the world, wouldn't it?
These were the five companions who set out from the Imperial City on an epic quest to recover the lost Amulet of Kings.
How could the Amulet of Kings turn Maroon into one of the Dragonborn?
Manimarco convinced Baron that the amulet could be used to perform a ritual that would rekindle the dragonfires. He claimed this would please Akatosh and entice him to adopt Verin as one of the Dragonborn.
I read out that. Why did Varys want to be Dragonborn?
By tradition, only the Dragonborn can lay claim to the Ruby Throne and rule as the one true Emperor by divine right. Verin conquered Cyrodiil and took the throne, but unless he became Dragonborn, he feared he'd always be thought of as a pretender.
Hmm.
Each of the five companions were chosen for their skill and courage, and each was given a special role to perform in the party.
Okay.
Who would you like to know more about? You've already met Lyris. She's a Nord warrior from the frozen lands of Skyrim to the north, and it is said that her family lineage contains the blood of giants. Baron chose her for her strength and her loyalty to be his personal bodyguard.
And the other ones?
Sai Sahan came from a long line of Red Guard Swordmaster nobles. He was the leader of the Dragon Guard, the security detail of Verin and the Elder Council. While Lyris was Verin's bodyguard, Sai was charged with protecting the entire group.
The mage?
The Therns are one of the most influential families in Cyrodiil. Abner, their patriarch, is the leader of the Elder Council, a powerful battle mage and a shrewd politician. With his council, Verin was able to seize the Imperial throne years before.
For what?
Manamarco the traitor, the great enemy, the most powerful necromancer this world has ever known. His worm cult infiltrates and corrupts every corner of Tamriel.
Cool.
It was he who convinced Baron to perform the ritual you are about to witness.
Ooh, we're about to see a ritual? Why not? Let's do it!
Disaster, war, and pestilence. A world brought to its knees. Now watch and see how one man's arrogance brought about the greatest threat our world has ever known.
I am the greatest threat our world has ever known. Let's just get that one straight for now. These are just drawn out, really drawn out. I mean, it sounds pretty cool, but
there it is. The
Hello.
Manimarco, are you certain this will work?
It will work, my lean.
Not 100%.
The Amulet of Kings will rekindle the dragon fires and ensure your rightful place as emperor.
Well, do it then.
It better work, Manimarco, or you'll find your neck at the business end of my axe.
My lord, I wonder if you'd muzzle your half-giant pet. She really is annoying.
Enough, both of you. We are here to ensure my lord's rightful claim to the Ruby Throne.
Abner, begin the ritual.
Just do it.
I have a destiny to fulfill. By the lighting of the dragon fires, I claim my rightful lineage. By the fires of creation, let me be reborn. By the will of Akatosh, I proclaim myself Dragonborn.
Okay.
Baron Aquilarius, you are no heir to Alessia. You will pay for your sacrilege. The veil between Tamriel and Oblivion tears and splits asunder.
What's happening? The sky is opening up.
Yep.
This is bad. This is very bad. Ah!
This isn't supposed to happen. What's the meaning of this?
Looks like Moloch Bar.
Marco, what have you done?
Gullible fools! The veil between Oblivion and this world has been torn. My master, Moloch Baal, is free to claim Tamriel for his own.
Akatosh, forgive me! Have mercy on our souls!
No. You're too much of an idiot to do that, to have mercy.
The ritual tore the veil between Nern and Oblivion, allowing Manimarco to begin stealing the souls his master needed to power the dark anchors and initiate the plane melt.
What went wrong?
Akatosh gave Alessia the Amulet of Kings as a symbol of his covenant with Nern. So long as the amulet remained in the care of Alessia's heirs and the dragon fires remained lit, Tamriel would be protected from the Daedra.
So I'm guessing... Yeah, what happened?
Manimarco tricked Varin into breaking the covenant, and the veil between Oblivion and Nern was torn. The Elder Scrolls named this event the Soul Burst. It gave Moloch Baal the opportunity to disconnect the souls of Nern from their hosts.
Okay. So what happened to the other companions, man? Did they go back to Moloch Baal?
Varin was lost. In the chaos of the moment, Sai Sahan took the Amulet of Kings and fled. Laris was captured by Manimarco and delivered to Cold Harbor, the realm of Moloch Baal. Tharn remains Chancellor of the Elder Council, and his daughter Clibio rules as Empress Regent. But the true power remains in the hands of Manimarco and his worm cult.
Well, how did you end up there?
When I discovered the truth about the five companions, I made subtle inquiries, but apparently not subtle enough. Manimarco got word of my interest and abducted me. He took me to Cold Harbor, where I remained a prisoner until you freed me.
They saw you as a threat then, my friends.
The truth is always a threat to evil men. Manimarco feared I would reveal his treachery, and if knowledge of Nan's vulnerability were to become known, it could threaten his master's schemes. Moloch Baal does not favor loose ends. Walk with me.
Okay. We've been walking a lot, though. Do we get to sit down soon?
Long ago was written, so long as the Amulet of Kings was borne by Alessia's heirs, Tamriel would be protected from the forces of Oblivion. But the Soul Burst tore the veil between worlds.
Oblivion.
And gave Moloch Baal the opportunity he desired. Moloch Baal's dark anchors pierced the torn veil and seek to draw Nern into the depths of Cold Harbor. These terrible engines of destruction have been appearing all throughout Tamriel.
Damn, look at that. Well, can I ask a question? What the fuck are we doing here then? Shouldn't we get the fuck... Like, shouldn't we do something about that? You know, like, I don't know, close them or...
If the Lord of Brutality and Domination is successful, he will merge our world and his own in a terrible plane battle. Few will survive the ordeal, and those that do will be enslaved for all eternity.
Okay. Can I talk to you, please?
So
there we go.
To us, Vistage. We must stop.
I'm ready to go back. Come on, let's just get the fudge out of this place. Because one, I'm getting tired. And two, I'm getting freaking bored. And those don't look like moths. They look like butterflies. Okay. Pulled your staff out of his ass again.
And so it begins. The remainder of the story has yet to be written. It is your story now.
You've given me a lot to think about.
And there is so much to do. But know this. You will not walk this path alone.
So what's our next move?
We must grow in strength and in numbers.
Numbers.
We need more than the company of an old blind man to alter the course of history. We must assemble our own group of companions. The first you have already met.
Lyris Titanborn.
Lyris sacrificed her own freedom to allow us to escape. She remains a prisoner in Cold Harbor. I must determine her precise location if we are to mount a rescue. That will take time.
What should I do in the meantime?
Minamarco's agents leave a web of lies and deceit. They pit the races of Tamriel against one another and divert their attention from the real threat. Seek out these agents wherever they can be found and expose their lies.
I'll do what I can, man. I'll do what I can.
Bringing you to my mind seems to have taken quite a toll on me. I must rest.
Please, rest. I'm no rush. And when I say I'm in no rush, I'm seriously in no friggin' rush to do this again. Man, that probably was the boringest part of this game so far. The storyline was really cool. Can I like that? Nah, you should be able to like that. But something about it, I couldn't get into it. I felt it was very disconnected to me. Let's get the fudge out of here. And do some more quests. You haven't unlocked the Harbinger. Oh, achievement unlocked. Achievement unlocked. The Harbinger. Right, let's take a look at our skill. I think we've got a skill. Oh, that's the wrong one. Skill point or something. Skills are not here. This is character. I can go up top. Find me skills. Skills is K. Okay. So we have one skill point. Let's take a look. Fighter skilled. Intimidate. So I can intimidate NPCs. This is perceive or persuade. I'm not sure. Blood altar. Conjure a fountain of blood from the enemies you have slain. Grants you greater fortification increase. 20% regeneration. Ally also activates a blood siphon to heal them of 40% of their maximum health. That's pretty dope. But yeah, what the hell, man? Racial the Kojita skills. That's armor. Too worried about that. We got alchemy, crafting, all sorts of stuff we can do. I'm going to do that later. Medium armor, light armor, heavy armor. I don't know. Weapon. It's like ooh, what's this? Triforce. Grants you a basic enemy attack. Use heavy fire by 30%. Heavy frost attacks movements by reduces movement speed by 30%. Heavy shock. Okay. Nearby enemies deal 10% of damage. Let's take a look at the bow. I want to get a bow though. I definitely want to get a bow. But I want to upgrade. Not that one. This one. Definitely want to upgrade that. Ooh, a passive ability. What is this? Increase the duration of Earth Heart by 10%. Nah. But that could be good as well. Iron Skin. Blocks an additional 5% of damage. Earth Heart is... Oh yeah, that's duration. And this one is nothing, because it's not there. Right, I still think we should upgrade this. Not spiked armor, sorry. Not this. This. Stone Fist. It's probably a powerful weapon to have. Right, let's... Ooh, stone giant deals knocks down for 3 seconds. Also, mana increases your armor for 75%. Ooh. Or we go for. We either go stick to the damage and it will increase our armor, or we go for more damage. Like, I'm all about that damage life. But I'm all about that survival life as well, so I'm not 100% sure which one. I'm gonna go for this one because it does pretty good damage anyway, and it doesn't do a lot more damage when it's, I think it's like 40, if that, like, more damage, but that 75%, that 75 plus armor for 17 seconds, that's going to come in handy, real handy. Enter curse mode by pressing dot, dot to dot. Come on, man, let's go. There we go. I love the way you tend to be in the floor. Find and kill. I gotta find people. What's going on here? Something's going on. I don't even know what it is, but. Oh! This is the dude! Hey, dude. I gotta find you. I guess I could do this mission. I'm here after all.